to everyone coming. There's so much more to say on this subject. I'll start by saying, you know, Linda and Tracy, your speech is very much, so I don't want to repeat you too much. But I just want to start by saying this isn't about money. This is a systematic attack on the human rights of disabled people. And when we talk about disabled people, what do we mean by that? We mean people. Only 17% of disabled people are born with their impairment. So 83% are silent during a lifetime. This means this is a human rights issue. Potentially, these cuts affect everybody. Anyone can become sick or disabled at any time. And when you become a so-called disabled person, you're just you. So I want to challenge disabled people, because we all have to be telling what to do. As disabled people have the same dreams and hopes and aspirations as anyone else. And you know what the huge irony is? The government rhetoric goes on and on about wanting to help disabled people become more independent, become more, you know, contribute more to society. Well, I know, as a probably best myself, that in order to do that, a lot of us need extra help and extra support. And the irony is, by taking away that support, you're going to make disabled people more dependent and less able to contribute. So the rhetoric absolutely doesn't make sense. If you want to enable disabled people to contribute to society, you need to support them, and you need to acknowledge that there needs to be funds put in place. Anything I've achieved in my life would not have been possible without extra support, and I know how valuable that support is. If you strip away that support from people, they will become unable to contribute and unable to lead independent and fulfilled lives. And that's why this is such an issue of human rights, because we're facing a time when disabled people are having to make choices like, will I leave my house today, or, you know, shall I go into care because I can't afford to leave my house? And this is the seventh richest country in the world is absolutely disgusting. We're told so much that this is about money. It isn't about money. I think the government are using this recession as an excuse to dismantle the welfare state. Generally, and it's part of the drive to transfer public money into private hands. Yeah. Make no mistake, this is what the reforms are about. If you look at the figures, I think DLA, the fraud estimated per year is £60 million, and yet the reforms are costing £710 million to implement, and companies such as the ATOS are on contracts of $1 billion a year. Now, I'm not good at maths, but even I can say that's not common sense. So we're already wasting nearly $2 billion to save $60 million a year. And then you've got to ask yourself, why are private companies now being hired to carry out assessments that GPs have carried out for years, where GPs are the experts of the patient and the condition? Why not leave that in the hands of the GPs? Why? Because GPs are less likely to work to target. So what do you have to do? You have to pay a private company to come in and carry out those targets for you. People like me, I was on DLA for life because brain damage doesn't go away. And now, millions of money in the next few years are going to be wasted, being paid so that someone can come to my house every few years and say, are you still walking? It does not make sense. In fact, these reforms are going to end up costing the taxpayers and billions of pounds in wasted money carrying out assessments of people with lifelong conditions. The clue is in the name, lifelong conditions. Those conditions are not going to go away. I'm not going to wake up tomorrow and not be wobbling. So it makes sense for society to just deem me as having a lifelong condition and give me the support for the duration of my life. Instead, I don't know like some of you guys in it, but a big challenge I've had there overcome my life is the challenge of like asking for help. I think a lot of people are proud and we kind of hate asking for help. And I've really struggled with that in my life. And one of the things that I hate about what's been done is that disabled people are having to beg for their basic human rights. Don't make us beg. You know, we don't want to beg. We want to be given the support we needed, but we don't want to have to crawl on our hands and knees for it. And that's what's happening. I really want to challenge this awful rhetoric that we're seeing in media, backed by the government, of course, that disabled people are a group of work-shy scroungers. And disability hate crime is going up because of this attitude they're really hardening. I get a lot of people who are suffering abuse. And you know what? I have never met a disabled person in my life who doesn't want to work. And those people who can't work spend their life wishing they could. So it's absolutely disgusting to portray us as a group of people whose life ambition is to sit on the sofa and watch Jerry Lee's fucking tail.
Those who did create
days, the credit crunch through their greed and their awful lack of responsibility, they're still being rewarded. In 2012, apparently, 50 bankers in London got £14 billion in bonuses. Now, that's more than DLA or EFA. That's more than the budget for the whole year. So we can see there is money. The problem isn't that there is money. The problem is there is a lack of will to put it into the public sector and to fund things like the welfare state. And what's happening is the welfare state is now being demonised. And we read about it every day, don't we? Our enemies are disabled people, or the immigrant, or the student, or the single mother. And it's classic divide and rule, because what they don't want us to realise is the enemy is actually above us all. We need to unite and fight for better. So I really think that we need to really fight this rhetoric, because it's so corrosive. And I kind of, as a taxpayer myself, I'm totally proud of funding the NHS, funding welfare. I think that, I think that's at the mark of a civilised society. I think that's brilliant. I want that safety net to be there. I think what we should be demonising is funding illegal wars that make other people sick and so I think what we're facing here in the wider context is we're facing a situation where we're heading towards a culture that is incredibly unequal and a two-tier society where only the elite has access to health, education and opportunities, and the rest of us are kind of bludgeoned so much that we don't have any expectation of life, of opportunity, of happiness. And, I'm here to say that that's absolutely not going to happen. It's an age-old power struggle. But I really believe from the bottom of my heart that, everyone, no matter what their ability, their colour, their sexuality, their economic background, no matter who we are, we all deserve the same rights to happiness and to basic human rights. And I think the government picked on disabled people because they thought we were a vulnerable group to target and we couldn't get together and we couldn't fight this. But you know what? Fuck them, we will.
Sure, guys. Please be talk and share this. I will be back in a couple of seconds. Thank you.